And then now, as he introduced myself, I am planting a church in Delaware District for Korean population.
Amen.
And as I checked through the internet research, there are about 3,000 Korean people within 20 minutes by car.
Wow.
Yeah, so they are so dense in a small village. And then I started this planting project from this May, and I opened a community service center for Korean people, and I taught English conversation and citizen preparation board, and computer and internet class, and some English Bible class, and some theater class, and so on. And there are about 40 Korean people attend this community services now, and about 7 people joined our Bible study. And I've never seen a Korean Adventist there yet. Yeah, so we have to challenge in spirit to the Korean people. So as you see that picture, there are several Korean churches in different denominations, and we have many SDA churches. So we can cooperate together with our SDA churches to approach to this Korean population. So I hope you will pray for our planting project.
Amen.
And when I arrived in Delaware from Florida, there was none I have ever met before. And climate and atmosphere, all environments are new to me. Mm. Yeah. Yeah, so it's so strange.
Yeah.
And even though I make a contract for the renter house, I've never visited that house. On the website, I found it and I sent a text to the house owner, and he sent me the contract form and signed on and sent it back and finished.
Mm.
And 1 month later, I moved into that house. And that is our home church. And that is our community service center too.
Wow.
And we are really satisfied with that place. And all Korean people praise about that place.
Amen.
Because they can easily access to the place. And the full basement was so calm and peaceful. And they feel comfortable there. So, even though I never visited that house before I made a contract, God already prepared for us, I'm sure. And then, as I attended to the church planters boot camp, the lecturers and speakers continued to emphasize that we need a core team to plant the church. But I have only 4 people in our church, including me, my wife, and 2 sons. And my first son is in the military service in Korea, and next year he will resign. So I'm not sure he will join us, but as now we have 4 core team members for this planting project. And the speakers in the church planting boot camp emphasize that we need at least 12 people as the core members. But we have only what?
Four.
Only 4. So one family have usually 4 members, right? So I continue to pray to send us 3 more families that we can organize 12 team members for this planting project. Do you think God will answer to the prayer?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Yeah. So within these 6 months, He sent us 3 families.
Amen.
To cooperate with us to this planting project. And we organized a board meeting, board members, for the community service too.
Amen.
And there are some Korean churches around our Delaware, and they sponsored in finance. So there is no lack of finances now.
Amen.
So when I opened the Bible, God gave us a vision through these passages. When I came to this Delaware state, I feel myself as a sycamore tree, planted in the ocean. God told to the disciples that if you command the sycamore tree to plant in the sea, it will obey. So I myself look like a sycamore tree planted in the sea. In culture, in language, in faith, all things are different. In this Delaware state, I felt. But I came here in the mind of obedience to the commands of God. And then, as I look at the people, especially the Korean people in the Delaware states, they look like sycamore trees too. Even though they live in Delaware state of U.S., they still speak in Korean. Most of them cannot speak in English. I so wonder why, how they can live in English language state. Only they speak in Korean. So, and then also they keep their own traditional customs and habits. So, and most of them haven't heard about our SDA beliefs. So when they join our community service and they heard some messages from our Adventism, they were so surprised. It was so new to them. So I felt these kind of sycamore trees have to be planted in the ocean of grace of Jesus Christ. Yeah, I felt like that. And the background of the story of Jesus in Luke chapter 17, verse 5 to 10, there was a tragic incident to Jesus Christ. He lost his brother John the Baptist. And he felt so sorrowful in his heart, and he wanted to be comforted by God. So he took his three disciples to the high mountain, and he prayed. After his prayer, God showed his future. He was changed, transfigured into a glorious figure. So it was a kind of sign to confirm himself to be glorified in the future. And then, while Jesus Christ took his three disciples to the high mountain, how many disciples were left behind? How many? Nine disciples left behind. If you were the rest of the disciples, how did you feel seeing those three disciples following of Jesus to the high mountain? How did you feel? Jealousy. Jealousy and envy. Yeah. And at that time, Satan tried to tempt them. He made a pit for them. So he made a boy who praised. And then there was a father who brought a boy to them, and he begged them to cure this poor boy. And do you think they succeeded?
No.
Why? Yeah. They like to expose themselves. They like to exalt themselves to the people. And so they failed. And after they failed, there are a lot of people around them rebuked and ridiculed. Especially the scribes insisted that Jesus is a kind of deceiver. He cannot make a real miracles. Because of whom? The failure of his disciples. disciples. Even though they tried to be recognized by his master, by their master and the people, but the result was absolutely different from their expectation. In that situation, Jesus came back to them with those three disciples. They were so glad to see their master again, who can work out this kind of problem. So they reported in detail what happened before Jesus Christ came back. So, and then they said unto the Lord, please increase our faith. So they knew the reason why they could not heal the poor boy is lack of faith. When they started their discipleship, they got a promise from Jesus that they will get the authority and power to cure the people and cast down the ghost. And then they, when they were sent to the villages, they experienced that many ghosts and devils cast down from heaven. Sometimes we feel the heavenly power and authority, but sometimes we feel lack of that kind of power.
Amen.
So we cannot be confident our own faith. Sometimes we look faithful, but sometimes we are not. As now, how do you feel? Are you full of faith now? I'm not sure. Yeah, sometimes we can be shaken. At this point, they were shaken. They felt lack of faith. So, Jesus told them with a parable about the faith. After the failure, the man cried out, "Help my unbelief." Who's that? The father who brought the demon-possessed son. And also the same thing cried out from the disciples. Increase our faith.
Amen.
Both of requests are same. I think all of us have the same cry or claim to Jesus Christ, right?
Amen.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you feel like that, then please concentrate to the passages and lessons Jesus Christ give to us.
Yes.
Jesus teaches about faith in Luke 17:5 through 10. He said in verse 5 like this. In verse 6, the Lord said, "If ye have faith as a grain of mustard seed." So first of all, he compared the faith as a mustard seed. And what is the faith like a mustard seed? In Hebrews 11:1, we know already about this passage. Let's read it together.
Faith is
the substance of things hoped for, and the evidence of things not seen. So the hypothesis, this is the original Greek word for substance. So from this word, we have the hypothesis, right, in English. Yeah, it's a kind of assumption or assurance.
Yes.
Yeah. And then the next one, evidence, is elenkos. Elenkos is a kind of proof to show the reality. And this is so same with the mustard seed. I have a garden as now, and several days ago I planted some seeds and scattered some seeds on the ground. And those seeds are already covered by the soil, so we cannot see anything. So we put some signs on each section. And on the sign there are some names of those seeds. So by that kind of sign, we know that this unseen seed will be that plant. Okay?
the seed of the mustard seed on the palm, yeah, it will be that tree. Okay.
Wow.
It will be that tree. So that is the substance and the seed, and it is evidence of the mustard tree. So Jesus' parable is the same, exactly the same, with the explanation of Apostle Paul. And then Genesis 1:26, God put in us in 1:26, let us make man in our image according to our likeness. So his image and likeness was put into ourselves. It's a kind of seed. Okay. What kind of seed? Yeah, 1 Corinthians 13, it explains faith, hope, and love. These three seeds are planted into ourselves from the beginning. And then, Ecclesiastes 3:11, he has also set eternity in their hearts. So what is already planted in our heart? Eternity. So we like live everlastingly. As like whom? As like God. So, what is the faith like a mustard seed? Jesus used this kind of parable from 7 to 10, a slave. This slave plowing, feeding cattle, and he came back home, and the master told him, prepare a food for him. And after preparing food, he continued to request some other duties, standing beside him and serving him. After that, he can eat some food. But after doing all duties, he said just like this, I am unworthy slave. I've just done what I have to do. That is the attitude of the slave. The faith like a mustard seed is like the attitude of this slave. The faith is not the knowledge. Faith is not what we know, but faith is the attitude, how we live. Jesus explains like that. So what is the attitude of this slave? First, humbleness. He confessed about himself as unworthy. He knows himself worthless without the master. And then secondly, he have eagerness to do what he has to do. So these two attitudes the slave had. And it's like these two kinds of attitudes can be found in two episodes. The first one, the father who brought the demon-possessed son. Even though he felt a lack of faith, he continued to hold Jesus' hands and cried out, I believe, but help me my unbelief. It is so paradoxical expression, right? I believe, but please help me unbelief. Yeah, it's like there are another episode in Matthew, chapter 15, verse 26 through 7. Now there is a mother who had a demon-possessed daughter. So mother and father can experience what is the real faith through the raising of their children. When the mother had a demon-possessed daughter, the life was not easy. Have you heard about that kind of troubles when you raise up your children? Yeah, we have many troubles, right? Because of our children. And when she brought her demon-possessed daughter to Jesus, Jesus did not hear what she said, even though she raised up her voice. He continued to ignore. And then he added one more insult. It is not the way to give the food for the children to dog. Have you heard about some insert? You are a dog. You are like a dog. How will you respond to that kind of insult? How did she do? How did she respond? Yeah, the love toward her daughter help her to have a wisdom, yeah, so that she can respond with some other words, even though the dog can get the food from the table. Usually the dog in the human society regarded as a worthless animal. They cannot join the table of the people. Many times they have to be isolated by the mainstream. When Jews lived with the heathens, they regarded them as a dog. So they did not accept that kind of heathen people among their society. So this woman knew that kind of atmosphere and culture in the Jewish people. Nowadays, in our US society, many minors feel like that. I'm also a kind of that kind of minor. Yeah. But she did not give up that kind of crying out to Jesus. When I came here in Delaware, there was none who can help me. And I have no money. I have only a small house. And then I visited many Korean people door to door. And they were not accustomed to the visitation without reservation. So sometimes they look me a little weird. And sometimes they did not open their doors. And sometimes they cast me out of their property. And even though I introduced myself as a community center director who visit their houses to survey what they have some need, what kind of needs they have. Only some people responded my visitation, and they filled out the survey form. And on the basis of the survey result, I opened some classes to meet their needs. And then I thought of the response from the Korean population there. I found about 600 households around me, and I mailed postcards to all of them. And then I thought there will be one or two responses by this postcard. Mm-hmm. As you've already known, in your mail box, there are only bills or junk mails. Nobody flowers, right?
Mm-hmm.
Just check, open, and then throw them away to the trash can.
Yep.
So I've already known that. So I expected only one or two people can respond to my postcards. But many times, God answered to my prayer double.
Amen.
How many people will respond? 24 people.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
At first time.
Wow.
Even though I visited 70 households door to door, only 5 people opened their doors.
Okay.
Nobody came to our service center. But by these postcards, 24 people.
Praise the Lord.
Registered, not just responded. Registered to our program.
Amen.
Very cool.
So I started with these 24 people, our community center. So I divided into 6 semesters, 6 terms in a year. So every term consists of 2 months. So the spring semester started from May to June. And then July and August, summer term. In the summer term, how many people can you expect?
How many?
Yeah, 38.
Praise the Lord. Look at that. Amen.
And this full term? Uh-huh. Yeah, 41.
Wow.
Amen.
So gradually,
yeah.
After they tasted our services,
yeah.
They have WOM,
yeah.
Word of mouth.
Yes.
Yeah. Spread to their friends and to their family members, and they still coming.
Amen.
And we need to open more classes. At first time, we opened just 2 kinds of classes, English conversation and computer class.
Mm-hmm.
And in the summer term, they requested us to open different classes, like the citizenship preparation course and cooking class. So we opened that.
Amen.
And this fourth semester, they requested us to open a kind of singing and musical instrument classes.
All right.
So my second son can play the piano and play the violin and play the guitar.
Amen.
So he is the teacher now. His students, my son is only 19 years old.
Praise God.
His students, the range of ages are about 40 to 70.
Amen.
Yeah. So 7 people crowded to the guitar classes now. So gradually, I felt that if I do not give up crying out, even though I feel like a doggy, a stranger, an outsider, and isolated, but God works with me.
Amen.
Jesus Christ worked within mother to cure the demon-possessed daughter.
Yes.
And then, as the result, the daughter felt the grace of God and transformed in her heart as a true Christian. And Jesus Christ have a promise to the disciples like this. If you have this kind of faith like a mustard seed, ye might say unto the sycamore tree, be thou plucked up by the root, and be thou planted in the sea, and it should obey you.
Amen.
At first time, I tried to introduce gospel to those Korean people.
Mm-hmm.
Most of them have the backgrounds of Buddhism and Confucianism, and they do not like Christianity itself.
Mm.
As you know, in Korean society, they ridicule Christianity nowadays because they have seen many kinds of corruption of Christian leaders. So they do not like at first. And they are not accustomed to the Christian culture. And especially our Adventist culture is more special than ordinary Christian culture. They've never heard of the Sabbath keeping. They do not know why we separate clean and unclean food.
Mm-hmm.
So one by one, when I try to teach that kind of biblical truth to them, they look like sycamore trees.
Mm-hmm. Look at that.
In the ocean.
Yeah.
It looked like impossible
yeah.
to plant them, plucked up from plucked up by the root
yes.
To the ocean.
Wow.
But I still try. Still try.
Amen.
So for 6 months, there are 4 people are interested in Bible study, Sabbath observance. And as of nowadays, on the Sabbath afternoon, there are 7 people regularly attending to our meeting.
Amen.
Even though they do not know well about the gospel itself and our Adventist doctrines. So I have a dream that there will be 300 Korean people, 10% of those Korean population
Amen.
Will join our Adventist church.
Amen.
And then I'd like to build up a community center for them.
Yes.
And then through this kind of community-based evangelical movement,
uh-huh.
I hope that our church will play the role for the community services and also gospel services.
Amen.
And I hope that all of us can have this kind of dream.
Yeah.
Or sycamore trees who never experienced the true gospel of Jesus
Amen.
Can be plucked by the root and planted in the ocean
mm.
of Jesus Christ's grace.
Amen. Amen.